Hey, good evening, welcome. We are the Beer Street Boys. We'd love you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can do it right there. Look at what we've got here today. We are very excited. Those of you who follow at home know that we love our German beers. We love it. But we also have had a great time with some Belgian beers over the years. What we've got here is a Rodenbach. It's been around for hundreds of years. And their speciality is sour beers.
Wow. Mm.
Now, we're known for not really appreciating our sours, and I thought a good thing would be to go back to the original and have a look at what these beers do. And the other thing I've been told is that sour beers go really well with food.
Mm.
So what we're going to do is we're going to try some of these beers, see what we think, and then also try them with the suggested...
Oh, look at that.
Got a bit of pairing going on.
We're going to try them.
Holy smokes. We're look how it pours out of the glass.
Wow. It's beautiful.
It looks pretty
amazing.
So what these fellas do is it's a mixed fermentation beer. They make the beer and then they put it in a large furder, which is not really a barrel, it's a massive tank made of wood, and they ferment it for 2 years.
Wow.
It is 2/3 2-year-old beer and then a third young beer.
Oh, wow. So they blend it.
It's wine-ish, I believe. But let's see what we think.
Certainly smells different straight off the bat.
Holy, what is that?
Well, you can get the sourness already, can't you?
I've got to prepare the tongue.
Wow.
Okay, so it's sour.
Yep. Holy smokes.
Definitely it's not tart. That watery sort of sour we've had before. That's got body to it.
I like that straight away.
Yep.
But you know what I can say?
Yeah.
Of all the sour beers that we've tasted over the last few months, this actually still tastes like a beer.
So there's this big thing about wild ales at the moment where it's spontaneous fermentation. So the yeast is coming in from the ether. But these guys, it's not. When they put it in the furder, then it goes through another
fermentation process.
Another fermentation. Okay. You might try some blue cheese.
Okay.
Or some grilled meat, but I just got a bit of roast beef and some prosciutto.
My fingers, my ones.
So I believe because it's a sour, you want that fattiness in the cheese. And also the blue cheese is gonna have that really...
Well, straight away you've got quite a strong flavour with another one.
So I'm going to have a little bit of beer and then I'm going to have the cheese. Mmm. That's a Danish blue. You feeling it?
That changed the flavour of it. It was immediately, because the blue cheese is also quite harsh and bitter, like the first instance on my tongue was a little bit sweet, followed by this amazing bitter.
Yeah, it's dry. You feel... The other thing, and I'm just trying this, they didn't suggest this, is that the beer is known for its apple characteristics. So I thought I'm going to compare it with a little bit of apple.
Oh yeah, see that now enhances the sour.
That's interesting, isn't it?
The cheese enhanced the sweeter bitter, and that apple just enhanced the sour with it. See, now this made me interested in sour beers.
Yeah, I mean, that's terrific.
This is making a lot of sense now.
There was a sour beer a few months ago there where we tried where I just thought it was soda water with a splash of lemon. That is way more complex.
I listened to a great podcast where the brewmaster was talking about it, and he was saying that he drank this from about 10 years old at the family table. That's what they do.
You're not going to have a six-pack of these just by themselves.
No, God, no.
This is a speciality that is just off the chart.
I think that's terrific. So what I found fascinating about this as well is these guys have been around, I think it's on here, something like 1821. The family was associated with Belgian independence. But during the First World War, they had a lot of money. They actually had treasure, like gold, buried underground. When the German army turned up, they were one of the biggest employers in the town. The German army was going around all the breweries and taking out the copper.
Mm.
And these guys said, well, we'd really appreciate it if you didn't take our copper. Here's a big chunk of gold. and could you also not kill everybody in the town? And they did.
And they did.
Both world wars, these guys emerged with beer in tanks.
Have I heard that story before?
This is from West Flanders. We know, it, particularly in the Second World War, it's a part of the world that was devastated.
Yeah. Mm.
And these guys came through.
I can taste the hundreds of years involved with that.
Mm.
You can.
Sour beers are not such a new idea or a new concept. But they had a purpose. And, you know, they were brewed for a long time to be enjoyed with food.
Yeah, exactly. Right. This makes a whole lot of
this
sense.
This has turned it on the head for me.
It's a song from the shed. Sweet, sweet, the memories you gave of me. You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Take sweet, sweet, one fresh and again.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Add one stolen night of bliss.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
I one girl and one boy. Some grief, some joy.
Tell me,
memories are many things.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me. Then add the wedding bells, one house where lovers dwell, three little kids for the flavor. Serve carefully through the days, see how the flavor stays. These are the dreams we'll savor.
Don't
sweet, sweet,
forget us.
Memories you gave me,
fold
sweet, sweet,
it lightly with
me.
A dream.
You can't beat the memories you gave me.
I your lips and mine,
two sins
are mine. Memories are made of this.
You can't beat the memories you gave me.
Memories are made of this.
You can't beat the memories you gave me.
This is interesting. Okay, same mix, 2/3, 1/3, but this one they put some cherries in. So this is Alexander. This is to celebrate Alexander Rodenbach, who was one of the founders. His 200th birthday in 1986, I think it was, because this is what people are doing now, is that you have the sours with the fruit in it.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Great example from our good friends at Brick Lane, which we didn't enjoy with watermelon.
Oh, no.
So this is...
Giving them a hard time. Sorry, guys.
Oh, look at that colour. Wow. Oh, my God.
Oh, wowzers. Look at it.
Okay.
There's cherry in there. There's cherry in there.
I can smell the cherry already. So, I mean, this is one that apparently you can have later. We've left the vintage till the end because it's a bit special, and I'll tell you about that in a second.
So what can I pair with this? What's the recommendation?
Well, I mean, I think any of these, but what they're suggesting with the Alexander is pork. We've got a little prosciutto there. Soft ripened cheese. So you want to try the brie. This is a manchego. It's a sheep's cheese.
Wow. That's different.
Well, there's cherry involved there.
There's definitely cherry in there.
Mm.
See, again, they say what it tastes like, and it does. That's got Christmas written all over it, hasn't it?
It does. Do you think the cherries improves it?
Yes.
I do.
110%. It just adds a new element. The other one was great. First time in a real sort of full-bodied sour beer.
Oh, that cheese.
That cherry on top.
My understanding with pairings, and I'm not a expert on this, is that you either want something that's contrasting or something that's complementary. So that the sourness, the tartness, and something fatty and rich just cuts through it.
Brilliant.
Oh, wow.
Salty and fatty.
That's great. That enhances the cherry for me, that prosciutto.
Aren't we fancy? We're so fancy.
Oh, look, it's all brasserie here. I'd love to see someone in Australia doing something like this.
Maybe they've tried.
Maybe they have. I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of the sour beers, and this has really changed my mind, so maybe we need to get out there and try a bit more.
I think there's something to be said for this, the fact that this beer was put in a cask 2.5 years ago.
Mm.
They've got 290-something casks,
yeah,
these big furders. So they'll go through and they'll go, I think this one is going to go well with this batch that's been sitting there for 6 weeks. I mean, is it science to it? And then also that when you're delivering beers like this that have to taste the same year to year.
And you just want to sip it too. You want to enjoy it with different things and just savour it. That's a flavoursome beer that you're not using it to quench your thirst or just chug it down so you hit the next one. I now know there's a beer that's got another purpose. Buy a six pack of this and find out what goes with it.
The carbonation is more along the lines of a sparkling wine rather than a beer.
So this is vintage 2017. It says Furter number 198. The brewmaster goes through and he tastes them all and he goes, that is the one we're going to put in the special bottle and send over to these bogans in Australia and see what they think.
See if they'll give us a...
I'm happy for that.
Awesome review.
We've drunk the two-thirds old and one-third new.
Yep.
And then the same thing with some cherries, but this is all old. Oh. Well, it would not really a champagne result, but it's...
It's okay. The fanciness of the bottle and the fact that it's all old, I'm ready to be blown away.
I mean, it's not mad. I think that was, $20, but it feels special. All right, similar colour. Actually, it's a little bigger too. This is designed for two people to share.
Oh,
it's not like a tallie in Australia.
Shall I leave?
if you're wondering why sometimes it looks like we're in the same clothes, we don't film these independently. We're sort of here for the day.
Look at how tight those bubbles are. That is fantastic.
Very small bubbles.
I don't think it's about the head. It's not like a
heifer. That makes a difference on mouthfeel, like I was talking before, how it tastes like a sparkling wine rather than a beer.
Yeah.
Beer bubbles are quite big.
Mm. Well, that's it. It's like a good champagne. Like
it tightens a
verve or something.
It tightens the feel on your tongue. Yeah.
All right.
Whee. That is interesting.
Wow.
Oh, but no. It just tastes
powerful.
Oh, I don't have the words. I'm unfamiliar with this style, but it just feels kind of darker somehow.
I really implore people out there who are beer lovers, and especially now people who are getting on board with the sour beers, if you think that you love sour beers, this really will change your mind about how you approach sour beer.
I get the vintage. I actually think the one with the cherries has been my favourite thus far.
I'm with you so far.
The blending, for me, is very cool. I don't think you find them everywhere. They mightn't be in the big shops. I got these from the Bowen Hills Beer Mart in Brisbane.
This one I kind of feel
this
like
is your least favourite.
Yeah, but I kind of feel like we just maybe haven't paired it with something that it really should go with. Maybe these just aren't hitting the mark. It was better with the soft cheese than it was with the beef, but at the same time, that it's just not matching, and I kind of feel like there would be something out there that it would match with.
They mentioned seafood.
Oh, really?
Or maybe prawns or something.
The crabs, yeah.
Yeah. And the other one, I mean, the Grand Cru, they suggested spicy food, which I know you love, Stewie.
Yeah, that's actually, yeah. That could
he was actually saying like a chili. He was saying chili con carne or something like that. But I do feel like the addition of the cherries to the Alexander just made it something really
special.
Interesting.
Hands down my favourite, but this one's got me interested. I don't know, and it's not my favourite, but this one's got me. What's the actual alcohol content of?
This is a little high. This is 7%.
Maybe so they're not crazy. I mean, I thought they were going to be way up there.
But I love the fact that someone, if I walked into this brewery, a gentleman will walk over and say, well, that bottle came from there.
Yeah. That's cool.
Get on YouTube and Facebook and Instagram. Follow us. Please give us a couple of comments out there. If you've tried some Rodenbach, give us a shout out. And
if anyone from Rodenbach watches this, you've won over three Australian guys who just grew up drinking lager.